Hi, my name's Chris, and I used to do a lot of drugs, but it's been 7 years since I've touched this stuff, and my drug of choice was actually opiates, and today, Taylor Nicole Dean announced that she's going to try getting off Suboxone. So as somebody who went through a cold turkey detox 7 years ago, I have some advice for Taylor Nicole Dean, as well as anybody else out there who might be going through this type of detox or withdrawal. But also for all of you out there, we're also gonna talk about what Suboxone is, some pros and cons, and some other stuff like that, so stay tuned. What is up, everybody? This is Chris from The Rewired Soul, where we talk about the problem, but focus on the solution. And if you're new to my channel, a couple things that I'm really passionate about are mental health and addiction recovery. So if you're into that stuff, make sure you subscribe and ring that notification bell. And make sure you follow me over on Instagram and Twitter at The Rewired Soul. All right, so in case you guys missed it, I'm gonna link a video up in the info card and probably down in the description below. But I made a video a couple weeks ago about the addict shaming of Taylor Nicole Dean, and I would really appreciate if you check that out, because it's kind of the language used around people who are trying to get clean and stay clean. But anyways, before I jump into my advice, I just wanna give a couple disclaimers for those of you who are new here and have no idea who the hell I am. I am not a doctor, and whenever I talk about Suboxone or medications, I always make it very clear, talk to a doctor, okay? So as we talk about Taylor Nicole Dean, she's currently in an outpatient program and they have medical staff there who is helping her with this, all right? So I'm not a doctor, I'm going to be sharing my experience. Like I said, my drug of choice was prescription opioids, and I actually worked at a drug and alcohol treatment center for a little over 3 years. We had everything from detox to inpatient to outpatient, and we did Suboxone tapers there. So I'm gonna share a little bit of my experience, all right? So those of you who aren't caught up with Taylor Nicole Dean and where she's at in her recovery, super proud of her. I believe she's coming up on 6 months, which is huge. Like, this is huge. Like, when I first got clean, I didn't think I was gonna be able to stay sober for 6 days, right? And I remember right around the 6 month mark, I heard somebody say this, right? And it really clicked for me. I heard somebody say, if I can stay clean for 6 months, I can stay clean forever, right? Because that's a long time, right? But anyways, Taylor Nicole Dean, she went through a treatment center, and when she got out, she was put on Suboxone. I believe she said, and you could correct me if I'm wrong, but when she made her video sharing about her experience in the rehab, she talked about getting off Suboxone and then she went back on it. All right, so first let's talk about what is Suboxone. Okay, so when you are using opioids or opiates, so prescription opioids, or you're using heroin or whatever it is, you become dependent, okay? Physically as well as psychologically. But when you stop using the drug, the opioid receptors in your brain are left vacant and you start to go through withdrawal, all right? And withdrawal is brutal. A lot of people can't get through withdrawal because the symptoms are so brutal, so they end up using. Well, Suboxone is this magnificent, magnificent medication that helps trick the brain into thinking that you're still using opioids, all right? Now, there are two different camps for Suboxone, okay? There is short-term and long-term Suboxone, all right? So Taylor Nicole Dean, like I said, she's coming up on 6 months at this time, so she's been on a long-term maintenance program. The rehab that I worked at, we were getting people off of Suboxone within about 2 weeks. The only reason we wouldn't get somebody tapered off of Suboxone in 2 weeks was if they had some other kind of like serious medical condition where it might affect them like in a negative way. I remember one young woman, she was actually pregnant, so we were waiting for her to discharge and then work on that with her her doctors back home, because that could affect the baby and everything. So anyways, a short-term and long-term, what's the difference? Why would anybody you know, choose one or the other? Well, Suboxone, although it is not an opioid, you can become dependent on it, all right? And that's one of the reasons people are so afraid to get off of it. But one of the reasons we did short-term is because after a 2 week taper, you haven't gotten that dependent, all right? So you figure the longer that you're using any substance at all, like if you quit drinking coffee or eating sugar or whatever it is, like you would experience symptoms of withdrawal, and it would depend on how long you've been like consuming caffeine or sugar on a regular basis, all right? But anyways, Taylor Nicole Dean tweeted this out earlier. My IOP thinks I'm ready to start tapering off Suboxone, so I'm going to document that experience for my second channel. Will be a very slow process and I might end up going back up in dose if it doesn't go well. But I'm looking forward to try to do this. And I am so proud of her. I retweeted it, I'm so proud. All right, so here's the thing I'm proud of. The attempt, all right? The attempt to get off Suboxone. I know people from the recovery community, from working in treatment and everything like that, who are stuck on this stuff for a long time. Some people are stuck on it for years. And if you're out there and you're still on Suboxone and that's your thing, do your thing, boo, right? But here's the thing, all right? Like, Taylor Nicole Dean, like being an influencer, and first off, like her just sharing her story very publicly and everything like that, her making the attempt to get off Suboxone is huge. It's huge, okay? Because here's some of the fears that I would have if I was on Suboxone, okay? It's, what if I run out of money and I can't afford Suboxone anymore? Then I'm just gonna have to go through withdrawal on my own. You know what I mean? And that's not being tapered off. So like Taylor Nicole Dean said, you know, she might go back up in dose, like they're gonna play it by ear and everything. Like if you run out of money for Suboxone and you lose your insurance, pff, you're screwed. You know what I mean? So here's the thing though. There's so many people afraid to do this. Now, I wrote a mental health blog the other day about getting comfortable with being uncomfortable. Like, let me tell you guys the number one reason that I drank and used drugs, all right? Like, us addicts and alcoholics, we have like a million reasons that we drink and use. But for me and many others, it boils down to one simple reason. And Taylor, here's my advice for you or anybody else who might be going through this, all right? But the main reason a lot of us use is because we cannot stand being uncomfortable, whether it's physically, whether it's emotionally, mentally, whatever it is. We will do whatever it takes to not be uncomfortable. And the thing is that our brain lies to us. One of the biggest lies that our brain tells us is that we cannot get through this feeling. We cannot get through this emotion. We cannot get through this pain, right? But this is a lie our brain's telling us. How do we know it's a lie? Because millions of other people have done it, okay? Like, I went through a cold turkey opioid detox, and I don't recommend it to anybody. Like, that's a whole different story I've talked about in other videos. But anyways, like, one of the reasons why people relapse when they're going through, you know, withdrawal, or, you know, they stay on the drugs is because withdrawal sucks. But here's the thing. Here's what I recommend to Taylor as well as anybody else, whether it's opioid withdrawal, alcohol withdrawal, Suboxone withdrawal, any type of withdrawal. It is not permanent, okay? It's going to suck for a while, but it will not last forever. Our brain has this amazing way of telling us that this feeling is going to last forever because there's pain, there can be nausea, there could be all these other things, there could be fluids coming out of different orifices of your body, but it does not last forever, all right? And I'll tell you this, one of the ways that I stay clean today is never wanting to go through that experience again. So I'm glad that I went through that experience. But for us addicts and alcoholics, one of the other lies that our brain tells us is that we need to put something in our body in order to feel better. And that is one of the biggest lies that an addict's mind will tell us. Like, I have been able to stay sober for 7 years because I realized that there is no emotion, there's no situation that I cannot get through. Like, if I'm being honest with you, I had a very stressful day. Today was very stressful, right? And I'm driving home, you know, from work, and I'm gonna come home and, you know, be with Tristan and everything like that. Like, having a beer, having a drink, you know, snorting something, taking something, none of that is on the table. And it's okay, and here's why. Because I know this feeling will pass, all right? Like, have you ever met somebody who's like, oh man, I still have this, like, this feeling from this bad thing that happened like years ago? You know what I mean? Like, feelings come and go. Our bad moods come and go. Our good moods come and go. Sickness, like, when it comes to withdrawal, we have to remember this. Like, When we, us addicts get really extra about withdrawal, like, I've been through it, I get it, and I know it can be worse for other people, but we get so extra. Like, we act like somebody's like amputating our arm without anesthetic, all right? Like, going through withdrawal, when it comes to like opioids or Suboxone, it is like the worst flu type sickness that you've ever been through in your life, but that's it. That's it. Like, you can do this and you can get through, all right? So a couple things, just some quick tips, all right, for anybody out there trying to get off Suboxone or opioids. Like I said, always talk to a doctor, do it with a doctor. If you have the resources, do it with a doctor. If you don't have resources, go to an emergency room. Most emergency rooms cannot turn you away, all right? But somebody like Taylor Nicole Dean going through Suboxone withdrawal, here are the things that help. All right, many friends and many clients I've worked with who have gone through Suboxone withdrawal and detox, they said these things help. First one is movement, all right, like exercise. Make sure you're moving. Don't just sit there stagnant or anything like that. Go for walks. If you like going to the gym, go to the gym. And I'm not saying like do some crazy like Rocky workout, like just get moving, okay? The second one is yoga, all right? Yoga is kind of the same as movement, but yeah, yoga is great too. Like, two of my like manly man like roommates who were going through Suboxone withdrawal, like, they started doing yoga and they said it helped them out the most. Now, not only does yoga help you get physically active and moving and everything like that and get blood circulation and all that, but it's basically moving meditation. So there's a lot of meditation practice in yoga, and a lot of meditation is learning how to accept your feelings, your emotions, any aches, pains, soreness that you're going through. It helps you deal with that by being mindful of it. All right, the next thing is nutrition, all right? Don't eat junk food. Like, when I say junk food, like, you know, like fast food and garbage food and everything like that. Like, if you eat better foods, it'll help speed up that process, all right? It'll help make withdrawal a little bit easier. But, like, something that really helped me out, not only during my withdrawal, but in recovery, is that I knew when I looked at the big picture of this thing, this withdrawal was gonna be that much of my overall life, right? Like, think about it. I've been sober for 7 years, coming up on 7.5 years this month. I went through withdrawal for a week. That was a blip on the radar, all right? And trust me, you guys, I am nothing special. The only way I was able to get through it was because I saw so many other people get through it. And Taylor, if you're watching this, trust me, once you get off this stuff, you're gonna feel this complete freedom. You know what I mean? And I could talk all day long, but it's nice not having to take something in order to feel well. You know what I mean? But anyways, if you guys have any tips, if you've ever gone through Suboxone withdrawal or anything like that, let me know down in the comments below. If you guys have any questions, if you want me to do follow-ups, let me know. And also make sure that you're subscribed to Taylor's second channel, where she's gonna be documenting her journey and everything like that. Not only will this help educate anybody trying to get off opioids or Suboxone, but I think it's really good for friends and family members as well, so you understand what your loved one is going through. All right, but anyways, that's all I got for this video. If you like this video, please give it a thumbs up. If you're new, make sure you subscribe and ring that notification bell. And a huge, huge thank you to everybody who supports the channel over on Patreon, as well as everybody who buys my mental health books over at therewiredsoul.com or Rewired Soul merch. You're all awesome. All right, thanks again for watching. I'll see you next time.